There are many ancient stories derived from religious texts, which, when taken literally, are simply illogical, easily disproven as that of a symbolic nature rather than literal documentation of true events. However, there are a rare few contested as literal truth, and a handful of these for good reason. The conviction is that these events left such a lasting impression on the creators of these texts and ancient scrolls that they included them within their writings. One of these being that of the so-called legend of the Tower of Babel. Once declared as a symbol of oppression, it is now argued by many as simply being merely another symbolic myth, such as many other stories found within religious writings. However, there are numerous details which cannot escape the microscope of some investigators. And now that a brick has been found, legitimately dated to this time, and commissioned by the same claimed king, the argument for the actual past existence of this incredible structure has gained traction within even the most skeptical academic mind. A brick, stamped with the seal of the ancient Babylonian king Nebuchadnezzar II, biblically stated as the man who commissioned the construction of the tower itself, has been discovered. Dr. Irving Finkel of the British Museum said, quote, "When you look at the early chapters of the Bible, it is clear that some of it is drawn from the Judeans' own records. It incorporates narratives which they must have encountered for the first time in Babylon, some so powerful and striking that the authors who worked on the Hebrew texts incorporated them to tell their own story." He continued, "In the book of Genesis, what we have here is a brick which fits exactly into that specific context. There can be no doubt that the stimulus for the story and the narrative must have taken shape during the Babylonian exile. The evidence could help to prove the existence of the Tower of Babel, its story written by a desperate population in exile held captive by a ruthless king." End quote. Yet, as always, regardless of the corroborating evidence, it will, like the many other details and aspects of the claimed tower, continue to encounter dismissal by many, with even those who are convinced of its past existence in disagreement over its original location. Logic would suggest that, if built, it was within ancient Babylonia, some 500 miles from Jerusalem. Yet some argue it was actually built somewhere else, within the Middle East. Regardless of these disagreements, we find the brick, its still intact mortar, Dr. Finkel's quotations, and indeed its intriguing seal, highly compelling.